For example, when I wake up in the morning and I prepare the coffee and I see Katarina, mm-hmm. our roommate, she's a professional singer, and okay. when she yawns, she's doing like,
yeah.
that is very, that is very funny. It's awesome, and it puts like good mood everywhere.
Yeah.
It's like, so yeah, and all the people, yeah, we are all cool and respectful, and so we and it's just the beginning. So we are starting to live together.
Relampada! Bem-vindos a mais um episódio da Relampada. O meu nome é Francisco Corte, eu sou o vosso novo anfitrião e antes de começarmos eu queria agradecer imenso, mas imenso, ao André, ao Alex e à Andrea por me darem esta oportunidade e pronto, a acolherem-me de certa forma na Relampada. Eles são fantásticos e pá, se não fossem eles eu ainda estaria a dormir na rua, é verdade. Mas agora, pronto, aqui no Estúdio 21, assim como o Harry Potter, eu tenho assim um quartinho por baixo das escadas e eu agradeço imenso. Muito obrigado. Antes de começarmos ainda, eu gostaria de agradecer aos nossos patrocinadores, que é o Bacardi Martini, que nos proporciona e sacia a nossa sede, que nós temos bastante, eu e os meus convidados. Ainda a Tulpa, que nos deu este ambiente florestal magnífico. E ainda... mas não menos importante, o Estúdio 21, que todas as temporadas proporciona espaço e é um lugar fantástico.
Uma salva de palmas.
Uma salva de palmas.
Depois, não é? Vamos dizer isso. Temos aqui também não é?
E sim, e temos aqui o Guilherme, que vai falar-nos um bocadinho, se ele não se importar, do que é que nos vai dar hoje.
Bem, hoje vou-vos trazer uma coisa da minha autoria, que é basicamente um whisky com sumo de limão, xarope de maracujá, xarope de gengibre e um top-up de kombucha com maracujá.
Kombucha!
Yum,
yum, yum, yum. Vai ser muito bom, vai ser muito bom. Ok, agora passando aos meus convidados, eu tenho comigo a Madalena Viveiros, que foi licenciada, não é?
Sim.
Em Línguas e Relações Empresariais, certo?
Ela
nem
é
a ver. Exatamente, pronto.
Yeah.
Também tens, és dona de uma loja de roupa
segunda
mão, não é?
Vezes,
que é a Calada Vintage, é certo? E a outra pessoa que temos connosco, and I will turn to English now because he's French, all the way from France. We have Pim, or...
João-François.
João-François.
Salve
de palmas. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, thank you.
João-François, or Pim, I'm going to call you Pim if you don't mind.
Sure,
yes.
Sure.
He's a biologist, am
yeah.
I right?
Yes.
But he wants to transition to marine biologist here in Madeira. Is that correct?
It is correct.
Amazing. Okay. Guys, we're going to start off with a question that I have for both of you.
Right.
And this, I decided, André, this is a question that I will ask every guest that comes through Relampada. Because
okay.
it's very important to
but
me.
But we're the first ones, bro.
Yes, you are the first ones. So, dogs or cats?
Ooh. I don't know if I can answer that question because it'll
or,
put me
or
on
something
a harsh
else, or
position,
something,
you know?
Or something else, I don't know. Could be something else.
Kim, would you like to start?
Yeah.
I'd say dogs.
Okay.
But
interesting.
I really like cats. I've had cats all my life.
Okay.
And well, cats like me. Actually.
Why do you prefer the cats over dogs?
I prefer dogs.
Oh, you said dogs. Yeah. Yes, that's true.
Yes.
Why dogs then?
Why? I mean, there's no like very specific reason, but I think that you
the
cat is wild. The dog is your best friend.
He's
like
friend.
Yeah.
So that's not the same relationship, but yeah, it's just. But I love cats too.
Mm. You had more cats than dogs, you said?
Yes.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
okay.
I just had one dog.
Okay. Well, what dog did you have, by the way?
It was a little bastard.
A little bastard? I don't know
with a
breed.
Broken. Well, yeah, it's a mix of.
mix of.
The king bastard. Was
king bastard, okay.
Yeah.
Was that his name?
And, Lufti was his name.
Lufti.
He had
yes.
I got it like. I went to the where the rescue
oh, okay.
center.
That's
for
really
animals.
Nice, yes.
And he had like a broken leg that wasn't fixed, and so that he had like this kind of walk. Like.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So he was very classy.
Yeah, definitely. Did you put him a crown on him? Like,
oh yeah, he had.
Because people dress up dogs.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, and he was very famous in Strasbourg actually. Everybody knew Lufty.
That's great. Okay, what about you, Madalena?
Well, I grew up with dogs, so
okay.
I have to say that for myself, like if I would bring a pet to stay with me and call my own, it would be a dog. But ever since I moved out from my parents' house, I've always dealt with cats. So I also developed a really nice relationship with cats. But yeah, dogs are, they are just happy all the time. You know, you just get home and they're like, whoa, she's here. So yeah, I like that. Cats are kind of, oh yeah, hi, can you feed me?
They do their own thing, right?
Yeah, which is also nice, you know. It's but yeah. To develop a deep relationship, I would say dogs.
All right, guys. All right. I will keep talking in English. I will talk to you in Portuguese in a minute, but I still have a question for both of you, and it's how did you two meet, and basically explain me how did you come to work together? Maybe talk about a bit about that.
Do you remember?
Yes.
Did we meet at the beach or the house party?
We met in Decathlon.
Decathlon.
It's true.
Interesting.
We did meet in Decathlon.
Of all places.
Yeah. I was there.
Decathlon.
Decathlon.
Okay.
It's a nice place.
So I guess you guys are do
it's
sports.
True.
Both
yeah.
of you.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. She was buying a skateboard actually.
A skateboard. Yeah. Oh, that's so cool.
It was this winter.
I'm a skater. I'm not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But we have a friend in common. She came last year in December, and then she came back with me in February and March, April. I was supposed to stay 3 weeks. We stayed 2 months.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
And we met at Madalena's place, and then we started to think about.
Yeah, it was that day in the Decathlon. You were with Marie,
yes,
right? And
yes.
Marie also lives with us in what we're gonna speak about later.
Mm.
And I invited you for a house party, wasn't
Absolutely,
it?
Absolutely, yes.
And then Marie was DJing.
Yes.
Yeah. My father cannot see this because he doesn't know I did a house party.
No idea. So you don't skate at all. Oh, why did you buy a skateboard?
Just to be cool, you know,
just
to have it around, be like, yeah. I'm
to put it in a wall.
Yeah.
Cool.
No, it was a birthday present.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That's nice. Então, Madalena, tu és licenciada, então, como é que tinhas dito?
Línguas e Relações Empresariais,
sim, mas
a.k.a. LRE.
LRE, ok.
Yes.
Licenciada em LRE. E tens a tua própria loja agora cá na Madeira, não é? Da Calada Vintage.
É verdade.
Como é que isso aconteceu? Estavas lá no continente, certo?
Sim.
Deves ter trabalhado lá também, com certeza.
Uhum.
E decidiste voltar aqui para a Madeira, assim?
Sim.
Sem mais nem menos? Ou tinhas um plano?
Não, não tinha plano nenhum. O plano foi coronavirus.
Coronavirus
That's
attacked.
What happened. That was
yes.
the plan, basically. Mas sim, olha, eu vivia em Lisboa, trabalhava lá como guia turística.
Nos tuk-tuks?
Não, nunca fiz tuk-tuks. Fazia carrinhas.
Okay,
ia para Sintra, Fátima, Nazaré, Óbidos, fazia aqueles one day trips. E depois também fazia passeios a pé na cidade,
okay.
que era super fun, adorava. Mas pronto, com o corona e tudo mais, esse trabalho diminuiu bastante. Ainda me aguentei em Lisboa um tempo, mas depois decidi voltar para cá e estamos mais tranquilos aqui, não é?
Sim,
querendo ou não, quarentena em Lisboa estava um pouco pesado, aquele apartamento, e aqui tinha uma casa grande, com nosso cachorro e tudo, então decidi vir para cá. Mas o projeto da Calada, ou seja, a loja em segunda mão, começou quando eu ainda estava em Lisboa. Eu digo que sempre foi há 2 anos, mas acho que já vão fazer 3.
Ok.
E isto é um projeto que desenvolvi com uma outra amiga minha, que conhecemos, que somos as duas madeirenses, é a Carlota. E conhecemos no 10º ano, na Francisco Franco. E depois ela pronto, foi fazer a vida dela, eu fui para a minha faculdade, ela foi para a dela, mas sempre mantivemos contacto e ela viu esta oportunidade no país onde estava. E lembrou-se logo de mim porque eu sempre gostei muito, sempre fui dos achados. Eu e minha mãe cresci com isso, porque a minha mãe também era muito das feiras e gostava de sempre arranjar dos leilões e tudo mais, então eu sempre tive também esse gosto, não é? E ela lembrou-se imediatamente de mim para este projeto e eu, ok, bora.
E de certa forma é bom, não é? Reaproveitar as roupas, o vestuário, em vez de estar sempre a comprar algo novo.
É a melhor coisa que nós podemos fazer.
Certo.
Por nós pelo nosso ambiente.
Concordo. E então, esse projeto não surgiu do Covid? Como a relampada
não,
de certa forma.
Não surgiu do Covid.
Okay.
Ele surgiu na Madeira graças ao Covid, sim.
Graças ao Covid.
Senão eu teria provavelmente ficado pelo continente, não teria vindo para cá tão
cedo. E tem uma loja física, claro.
Sim, então...
Queres fazer uma plugzinha do lugar?
Antes ia sempre fazer, em Lisboa fazia sempre feiras, ou seja, andava sempre com a casa às costas, assim meio... complicado às vezes, era muito cansativo, e quando transferi todas as coisas aqui para a Madeira, o Odinô lançou esta open call para projetos.
Sim.
E acharam o meu projeto interessante, eu candidatei-me, não é? E fiquei lá com uma pop-up store por, acho que foram o quê? 3 meses, 4 meses? Entretanto, começámos o nosso projeto juntos, não é? Os 7 na casa.
Certo.
E passei a loja para lá, portanto agora temos uma garagem. Storm, montámos uma loja na garagem que acabou de abrir há 2 dias atrás, portanto passem lá.
E onde é? Onde é?
É na rua Doutor, como é que se chama? What's the name of our street? I always forget. Rua Doutor Costa Ferreira.
Costa Ferreira.
Número 6, yeah.
6. Rua Costa Ferreira, número 6, não se esqueçam, está lá uma pop-up store.
Escolha mamá.
Yeah. Do Calada Vintage, ok? Back to English. Ok, Pim.
Yep.
So, you are a biologist.
Yes.
What are you doing in Madeira? Tell us, why did you come to Madeira?
Why? Because I kind of fell in love with the island.
Is it?
Yes.
You're not like in the Interpol or anything like that?
No.
No?
No. Oh, no.
Okay.
Nice.
All right.
That is awesome.
We have some delicious drinks. Where's mine?
Ah, you also got one.
Thank you.
Well, cheers.
Cheers, guys. Thank you. My first guests.
Oh, already?
I didn't know.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Wow, it looks beautiful. Cheers. Obrigada. Cheers.
It looks beautiful.
Guilherme, isto está... Esmeraste hoje.
Olha, eu já me molhei. Mas não molhei, eu só não molhei o
aqui?
Tapete, estás a ver?
O Alex está aí. Cuidado.
Alex, o tapete está a salvo.
O tapete está a salvo, eu já avisei. Podes deixar aqui a bebida se quiseres. Pam, you can put it on that little table if you don't mind.
And answer your question, maybe.
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah. So yeah, you are from Interpol, as we established.
Yes.
And you are a biologist.
Yes. Right?
So and you came to Madeira.
I came
Keep
to Madeira.
Going.
Yes. I came here to Madeira to. I just created an association, which name is Feliz Collective.
Oh.
And
Feliz Collective.
Which purpose is to create and develop the interactions.
Is that something you wanted to do when you came over?
Yes.
Oh, the start you wanted to do that?
Yeah, okay. And the idea is to create and develop interactions between Strasbourg, the city of Strasbourg in France,
okay.
And Madeira, Funchal, in terms of art, like music, tattoo, street art, graffiti stuff, paintings, and also it has a scientific component.
Okay.
I like that's what I studied, and I like to focus on environment protection, marine biology, understanding the ecosystems of those countries. So I have to go for that. I'm working and I'm trying to contact local person that are doing this kind of project.
Okay.
And so we'll see. And I'm looking also for partnerships.
Yeah, of course, definitely. Have you done any surveys in Madeira since you've arrived?
That's what I'm doing currently.
Okay, what can you tell us so far? Are we doing okay here in terms of environment?
I think so.
Madeira?
Yes, it is very interesting. I mean, and I'm gonna talk with people in the university and also people working in Quinta do Lord.
Quinta do Lord, yes.
Quinta do Lord, yes. And I'll see. But now that's just the beginning. And we're trying to set it up with the Escola Normal collective too. Yes.
So this institution, let's say, that you created, where you have this culture of art, basically, is this something you always had passion about? As well as the biology, or
yes, kind of.
Because I can see you have like the tattoos.
Yes,
and
yes.
You told me earlier that you plays
I play drums.
He's very good at it.
I started just 1 year ago during the lockdown. So let's say I know some basic stuff, but I'm not ready for
me
a
or
life.
You're a professional.
Oh yeah, thank you.
Is good? Is that good?
Yeah, for me at least. Wow. I mean, if you give me a set of
it
drums,
must be really tough though, like playing the drums, like.
That's good. And yeah, it's relaxing.
You find it like just to like get rid of the stress.
Yeah,
like, just
yeah.
I need to try that.
Sure.
Yeah, that
sure.
Must be really cool.
And nunchaku also. It's very relaxing.
The what?
Nunchaku.
We're gonna talk about that.
Oh, oops.
Okay. So if you had to pick like one of the arts, like you have tattoos, you have music, you have I don't know, movies, acting, whatever.
That's gonna be
tricky. Singing.
Ceramics.
What would you pick? Or would you pick biology? You wouldn't pick biology, I'm sure.
I will pick biology because
all
that's
the
understanding of our own condition.
Okay.
So, yeah.
What about, but if you had to pick on the...
But the biology is here because it's full of flowers.
Okay.
Tattoo flowers, yeah.
Is that what it means, the tattoo, your tattoo?
Yeah.
What's the meaning?
Lot of skulls and and flowers.
Okay.
I've been doing archaeology, so I'm used to discover bones, dry bones and stuff like that. So I like it.
Oh my god, that's amazing. Okay, so I think we're gonna do a little game here.
Let's do it.
If you guys don't mind. Yeah. Which I like to call it... how would you say this in English, Andre? I will say it in Portuguese, but I'm just curious. Explain me this.
Explain me this, but this with D-I-S.
Yes.
Like this.
This.
You know?
Oh,
this.
Nice.
Like, we are like...
Explain me this.
This.
We're evolved like that. Explain me this.
Announce
Mas
the game.
Em português é... Explica-me isto.
Andei a vasculhar as tuas redes sociais e vi este retrato. Explica-me isto.
Explica-me isto. Who sings this? Quem é que canta isto?
Tiago Sena Silva.
A sério?
Yep.
It's tão engraçado.
It's tão engraçado.
Isto é a mistura das duas. Telemóvel, que já me caí. Ok, o explica-me isto basicamente é: eu fui às vossas redes sociais. I'm going to speak in English. I went to your social media, as you guys know, and I saw some curious pictures of you both. And I will ask you, don't worry, nothing compromising. And I will ask you to explain me this. If I'm not satisfied, you guys will drink a shot.
Oh, right.
Call Guilherme, he ran away.
Right. Yeah, Guilherme ran away.
Okay, I'm gonna start with you, Madalena. I have this picture. I don't know if the camera
will
see.
What are you showing to the world? Oh yeah, nice.
So, do you want to talk about this?
That's
it's
Boom Festival. What is there to
what
say
is
more? Boom Festival.
Boom
you?
Festival.
That's me, looking gorgeous.
Where
there,
is
right?
this? Where is Boom Festival?
Where is Boom Festival? It's in...
Amazing.
I forgot the name.
Never went to.
People that go to Boom Festival, don't get mad at me. I don't remember the name of the place.
Okay. But the city, maybe?
Yeah, não me estou a lembrar.
Okay.
It's a huge lake, uma barragem. And the festival happens all around it. It happens every two years.
Sim.
And it's just amazing.
What is this statue? Did they put it there for them?
Yeah, there's different artists. So every year that they do it, they have a theme. And there are several artists that go there to make their own creations based on that theme.
So it's not a music festival, it's like a...
It is a music festival.
Oh, it is a music. What
it's
kind
a
of music?
Trance music.
A what? A trance?
Trance.
Okay. Yeah. Psytrance.
Psytrance. But it's not only, so you have the main stage where it's more like psytrance music, and then you have musics of the world, you have lots of meditations, you have lots of workshops, and it's a huge festival. You have Baby Boom, where you have all the babies running around. And yeah, it's really, really fun.
So,
and it's in a beautiful place. How did I forget the name of it? It's I went to for 2 years.
Mm,
yeah,
okay.
That was the last year I went.
So you would say music is very important in your life.
It's
spiritually
essential.
And sorry.
It's essential.
Essential. Okay.
Essential.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
I would ask for a shot here. For Madalena.
Why?
Because you're not satisfied?
No.
I wanted more.
She didn't say the name of the
place.
Absolutely. I want to go next time.
It's not sick. Come next time.
No.
I don't want to drink a shot.
Yeah.
Don't do this to me.
Okay. It accumulates.
No, I took like a print screen.
How did I forget?
It's okay, but it's okay.
No, I'll get Guilherme.
I can see.
No, Mother Winner will take the shot.
Yes. I'm sorry, boomers. Don't hate me.
Yo. I have this picture. I don't know if the cameras can see it. But it's... You have a telescope.
Guilherme will be here in a minute.
Yes, Alin, I was sure you would pick up something like this.
Yeah, because your Instagram is full of moon pictures.
Yes.
So could you talk a little bit about this?
Well, I have two telescopes.
Your passion. Two telescopes, okay.
Yes,
okay.
One that you set up manually, and the one I have here, it's like... you can work it with the computer.
Okay.
Yeah, Wi-Fi stuff, it's pretty awesome.
Interesting, I didn't know that existed.
And I came all the way from Strasbourg to Madère with the telescope.
You managed
to
bring
like
it?
Like 25 or between 25 and 30 kilograms. Right?
Whoa.
So that was kind of like, yeah, but worth it because now it's set up and it's cool, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we can see the moon, for example, Jupiter and Saturn.
Yeah, the planets.
It's like you're almost
there. Yes, it's
there.
Like yeah.
Especially with the moon, you look through that little thing, like.
You think like you can touch it, and usually what you expect as a reaction from people looking through the telescope is, oh shit!
And it's right there, right? Like it's like you said, you can almost feel it, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's amazing.
See all the craters. And
but
yeah.
Where did that this passion come from? You wanted to what?
Oh, I don't know. But
do you believe in astrology and
astrology? Yes and no. I believe in the configuration of the planets for sure, but not in this like okay today that's gonna happen. But yeah, astronomers they say like when you like to see through the telescope, that means that the cosmos, the universe, is talking to you. So you're just trying to answer by looking at it. And I bought my first one when I was 20, in 2000. Yeah. And I try to do it like as much as I can.
Have you guys ever seen the
shooting stars?
Well, the shooting star is difficult because it's very
yeah.
I wouldn't
fast.
Say from the
it's
telescope,
it's
but let's say
oh,
even
yeah.
looking at
oh,
the
yeah.
sky
yeah,
and
yeah.
stuff.
Because like
here I was in Fayal once with a couple friends, and there's no like
interference
like,
from the
lights.
Lights,
like, you know, the pollution,
light
pollution.
Yes,
light
yes,
pollution.
Yes, yes.
There was none like in Fayal, and we saw like three or four.
Mm-hmm.
We lay down on the floor, look up at night,
but
of course.
But it's, I mean, I think it's in August.
Yes.
There's a certain
yeah, like
week
yeah,
in August where you can see a lot of falling
stars.
Yeah,
it was around
exactly.
that time.
Exactly.
Yeah,
think,
it's amazing.
It was around
yeah.
that time. I think
when
it
was
either July or August. Yeah.
When I was a teenager here, we would go, a group of friends every year, just lie on the floor, lots of blankets.
Exactly.
Blankets.
And it's amazing.
The winner needs a shot.
Really? You didn't, you didn't
this
let this go.
Do you
okay,
want a shot, Pim?
This is fair enough.
It depends. It's up to
you.
I really liked your answer.
You like the answer?
But so I'll have one.
I'll take one anyway.
Two. One for me and Pim. I would say, yeah, it was amazing because I never seen them.
But you're very welcome to pass by the house and have a look at.
I'd love
please.
To. I would really love to. I'll
you
go
guys
with Andre.
Have to come.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
I have
see.
Been there. Ba ba ba.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it's very cool.
Thanks.
Oh, you've been there.
Yeah, I've been there.
Oh, that crazy part.
It's not that crazy.
No,
it
was not that
cool
crazy. We got a baby in the house.
It was a crazy
party.
Yeah, they have a baby, yeah. So
keep it cool.
Yeah.
Tell us.
Cool, responsible party.
Yeah.
Yes.
Tell us, Alex,
yeah.
about this crazy party.
It was not a crazy party. I don't know who invented that. It was actually quite, you know, very relaxed moment. It was
okay.
very nice.
Oh, cool.
And it's kid, friendly. So
yeah.
It's cool.
Kids friendly.
You can go and take
that's
your
good.
Kids, too.
Anybody can go.
Yeah.
Okay. That's good. All right, I have another picture of Madalena. I don't know. Do I show it to the camera, Andre?
Yes.
First? Okay.
Yeah.
And then I'll show it to you. This is another event.
You're going through my years of festivals.
Yeah,
what should I say about it?
Oh, let's have the shot first.
It was fun.
Let's drink the shot
it.
First.
Let's drink it.
All right.
Oh, you didn't drink the shot.
She
cheers.
Was waiting on us.
I was waiting. Oh, damn it.
It's on a long drink.
This is why I'm here, guys.
Tá fantástico. Oh, tá muito bom.
I like the glass, actually. It's
pretty. They're
pretty
cool, yeah.
That's cool.
It's like a
tá
bom,
tá bom. So this is another festival you went. Talk about this festival. You like festivals.
I love
festivals.
It's all about the festivals. Well, these days, I mean. Yeah.
If you want to make me a happy woman, take me to a festival. All
right.
Oh. That's all I can say. I don't know. I love being outdoors. I love loud music. I love to feel the freedom to be either inside a tent with loud music or out in the nature, so festivals are great for
Where was this festival? Do you
I don't remember.
It seems like when Madalena goes to festivals, yeah, she kind of like forgets where she is.
Why do you need to know where you are? Oh, you know, like...
Like, pretend it
was this is
if
true.
A friend comes to you and says,
this is true.
I'm going to take you to a cool place where there's loud music, lots of people, and nice nature. You don't really care where exactly you are. You
but
just get in the car
remember,
and you go.
Right?
Yeah, but, I mean...
If you want to go back one day, I mean...
Remembering is cool.
The remembering is really nice, but I remember other things that for me are more important than where it was.
You realize that you will have
But it was in Portugal also.
It was in Portugal. Oh, the other one was in Portugal as well. Okay. I didn't know that. Because I asked the country and she's like,
drink another shot otherwise.
So
that's okay. If they want to get me drunk, what should I do?
Okay, guys. That was a good answer, I guess. She said it was Portugal. So, Pim.
Yes.
Let's talk about the Nachacos.
Oh, wow. That's another passion of mine.
Damn, this is badass. This is really cool. Are you really good at them?
Good, I don't know, but I practice, yes.
Okay, talk a little bit about this.
That's cool. Yeah, it's something... I like martial art. Like, I practice judo. Mm. And this nunchaku, it's very relaxing, actually.
Okay.
When you go home, you're a little bit frustrated because of, for some reason today, you just grab the nunchaku.
And sometimes you hit yourself just to...
Sometimes you hit yourself.
I was going to say, like, I'm sure...
It brings you back to the ground. I say, oh.
Like, literally to the ground? Yeah. Oh, okay.
I hit myself. Maybe I'm too aggressive. I'm too nervous. So it's a good way of relaxing.
Yeah, I was going to say, I can see that you are a person who likes to take the frustration out of your shoulders by doing some activities, like using the nunchakus.
Like it has nothing to... No reason for the frustration to be inside me.
Mm.
I don't like it.
You don't like it? So you want to be free?
Yeah.
So
I take it away.
So you just like, because of the passion for martial arts, you just decided to do...
Well, I bit my first nunchaku when I was 12 with pages, paper sheets, you know, when you use to write your lessons and stuff, and tape, and a string. And
in class?
Well, no.
Okay.
My
I was gonna say your teachers.
Home. No.
Oh, that's fine. Okay.
But I kept it for quite a while, and then I said, "Oh, okay, I'm gonna buy some nunchaku," and I've always had nunchaku ever since.
Hmm.
That's kind
You're
of
the gadget man in this.
Yes, yeah.
He's so full of gadgets. Like every
really
day,
cool.
A new thing is coming.
Yeah, that's cool. I like
yes.
objects and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true.
That's amazing.
It's
is it creepy? No.
No, it's super fun to live with you.
I think it's badass. I don't know. Should we have another shot, guys, or?
Oh wow! Ooh. Where is this going?
Francisco likes shots.
I like shots. So
let's do it. I don't care.
Let's do it. Yeah.
That's a yes.
It is a yes.
Just
yes.
don't pour me any gin. I don't deal well with that.
It's Martin.
Thanks.
Martin is always good.
Yeah. What is this shot?
It's Martini Fierro.
Fierro.
With the passion for the ginger, so you don't get out of team. And a bit of whiskey. Of course.
Bravo.
Madalena doesn't like whiskey, but she's hyped for whiskey.
She's
now.
Hyped for whiskey now.
Yeah. If you know how to serve it.
Oh.
I'm just here with an energy bar in my belly, so like, yeah. Amazing.
No, I mean, this has whiskey, right? This drink here.
Yeah.
I
Everything
don't feel it
whiskey.
At all. It's
good.
No,
cool.
No,
thank
true,
you.
Right.
It's a cocktail. So.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay.
Whiskey is Dewar's, right?
Yeah.
Dewar's. Yeah. Like the bottle you have beside.
Yes, dealers.
Oh.
I will take it home once this show is over.
That's your payment.
It's my payment, guys. Help me. Anyway, Madalena, no to you Instagram. I'm going to turn to Portuguese. Sorry, Pim. You have tu tens uma frase que diz: "You belong to nature, nature belongs to you."
Ooh.
Fala-me um pouco disso.
I know, I'm deep
depois
sometimes.
Do shot.
Obrigado.
There you go.
Não bebes connosco?
No, I can't.
Now
Why?
He's working.
Yeah, I'm working. I don't drink water.
We're not? What are we doing here?
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Woo.
Bottoms up. Woo. Yeah.
That's a bingo.
That's very good.
Mm. You belong to nature, nature belongs to you.
Yes.
I guess it just
Talk
means for
that.
Me that, we're all the same. And I think as human beings, we forget that we are also beings. We're not like a separate thing.
Mm-hmm.
And our society is just made to make you believe or unconsciously see yourself as something apart, and that everything that is around you has to have a purpose that serves you.
Podes falar em português também.
Ah, yeah, pois é, desculpa. I want to be inclusive.
No, that's good. That's good. That's good.
I appreciate that.
E não sei porquê, agora como vivo com pessoas de vários lugares, parece que me sinto mais à vontade até em falar inglês. Mas vamos para português. Mas o que eu estava a dizer é isso, acho que essa frase, nem sei de que foto é, só de onde é que tu tiraste
isso.
Não
me lembro, procurei.
Mas acho que é um pouco essa a ideia. Nós pertencemos à natureza, a natureza pertence, nós somos parte.
Parte da natureza, não é?
Yeah.
Sentes-te que... tu, tipo, realmente... Poxa, exato. Ela, antes de começarmos, ela estava a dizer que adorou o facto de estar rodeada de feathers, exato. És vegan ou vegetariana?
Eu sou simpatizante.
Ok.
Isto o que é que quer dizer? Não cozinho carne, nem tento não consumir carne ou derivados, apesar de que gosto muito de queijo.
Ah, eu adoro queijo também.
Eu tenho muita dificuldade em abdicar do queijo, mas eu vou conseguir um dia.
E ovos?
Já consegui.
Não como?
Já consegui parar de comer ovos.
Ok.
Houve um dia que eu olhei para um ovo, abri um ovo e olhei para aquilo e disse, isto é estranho.
Seria um pinto.
Foi isso. Isto é estranho, estar a comer isto. Portanto, yeah, mas sei lá, às vezes, quando tenho um amigo que vem visitar e quer ir comer uma espetada...
Oh, sim, eu ouvi uma costeleta do confiado.
Ai, Alex, não falas de mulher.
Mas tento... Mas tento evitar o máximo.
Só com sal.
Yeah, peixinho também é difícil.
Oh, lapas.
Lapas. Também. Pim is on a Lapas diet since he arrived.
See? Pim wants some Lapas.
At least, where are every day?
Every day? Oh, if you could?
Oh, okay.
No, that's why he's in Madeira.
Oh, he can, okay.
So he is doing it.
Lapas is the shit, right then?
Okay.
It is.
Oysters, maybe?
Oysters. I prefer Lapas, but oysters are okay too. I suppose, yes.
Lapas forever.
Lapas forever, yes.
That's a cool name.
Oh. So yeah, Pim, you live in a house full of artists.
Yes.
So what is that like? Talk a bit about that adventure, the fact that you live with a group of people, because I'm assuming like back home you didn't, right?
No.
No, but here is a brand new world.
Yes,
it full is. Full of lapas well, and full of a house of people.
Absolutely.
Talk about that. Yeah,
that's a dream. well, that's pretty interesting.
How did that come up to be, like? All these people together in one place.
It's cool, and because the house is really cool, you have a lot of spaces. I mean, we are not living on top of each other. I mean, we have our own privacy if we want. Mm-hmm. That's cool, and it's interesting because we're all like, you know, we have the same behavior, we have the same way of thinking stuff. So it's interesting. And for example, when I wake up in the morning and I prepare the coffee, and I see Katarina. Mm-hmm. Roman, she's a professional singer, and when she yawns, she's doing
like,
that is very funny. It's awesome, and it puts like good mood everywhere. Yeah. It's like, all the people. We are all cool and respectful, and which is just the beginning. So we are starting to live together. So
you guys working on something together, like.
Since
you live together, do you guys think, like, planning together as well, like projects and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about that?
Well, yes or no.
Okay.
Well, that's the beginning. I think, but we're just, like, creating events, like jam sessions, or movie projections.
Yes.
And yesterday we had also a painter coming to our house. And so
a painter?
Painting session.
Oh. So
did you paint?
Yes.
You guys painted?
I couldn't. I was working on something else, unfortunately.
I painted like a...
But next week, maybe.
Did you do like a Mona Lisa? Like yesterday we had a woman here drawing...
Doing the Picasso,
Picasso. She drew Picasso in 30 minutes. Like, it was really good. It was. What about you, Pim? What did you draw?
So Oliver, the painter, came and he said, okay, let's look at something that could be interesting to paint. And say, okay, we have a table, like a wood table, which is really nice. And he said, okay, let's put some fruit and a water jar and let's do it. And I was like, oh. Okay, and we started, and I did something. I'm not very satisfied with it because it looks like my 4-year-old baby drawing. But they said, it's nice because at least you did it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Madalena, Catalina, she said that it looks like a Henri Matisse style.
Okay.
Thanks. but thanks. And well, I did it, and it's very cool because I don't remember last time I painted something. I was like maybe 8 years old.
I would say the same. Yes.
Yeah.
I
don't but that, it's cool to go back to the
like some roots.
Do it.
And like,
yeah.
Interesting.
And to see like Oliver, the professional painter, like
the
well,
so
like,
way
you know,
here.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he must have like.
Yeah, yeah. I took some cool, interesting.
Did you try
photos.
To like mimic too? Like.
Yes.
The same. See if it comes out the same. Yeah.
But that's cool to see how a person can be focused on the on his art.
And he was there for many hours, right?
Yeah.
Do you see it yourself that way too? What when you focus on something, focus on your art, like it comes out beautiful. On your own thing, of course.
Yeah.
Like.
But I'm learning different things like painting and maybe singing.
Yeah.
Oh really?
That's the cool
thing.
Would
you do it? Like,
why not? Yeah.
Sorry, Madeline.
It's okay. Sorry for interrupting. But I think that's the cool thing, the coolest thing, at least for me, about what we are doing here with the Escola Normal, is we are seven people in total living there permanently, at least for now.
Seven, okay.
And each one of us comes from a different background. We each of us have their own interests, and we're each one of us really good at something else. And then it's really nice to just put all that together and experiment with each other. And that's a bit what we want to do, but not just with the people inside the house, but also to invite people from outside the house to come and have that experience with us. So with the jam session, we want people to just grab an instrument, try it out, and interesting things happen from there. If you have a project or a place in which you would like to throw your workshop, do a yoga session, do, I don't know.
Meditation.
Ceramics.
We could talk about that too. Yeah.
Ceramics class, whatever. If you have something and you need a place to do it, and
did
a good
you find
environment
a passion?
To do it.
Did you, Madalena, find a passion?
For what?
Like, you said it's an inviting place to for people to discover.
Mm-hmm.
Did you discover anything?
I'm discovering.
Oh, you still
I'm
discover.
Always discovering.
Okay.
Every day in the house I'm discovering
start playing
something.
The drums, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
What about you, Madalena?
Well, so far I've been very focused on setting up my shop and all the stuff.
Oh,
so
yeah,
it's
you
been
have your business, that's
more,
true.
Yeah, but I already had the chance to jam a little bit in the studio with everyone. That was really fun to play a bit on the keyboards and see the different sounds and try to make it work together with what all the others were doing. So a sparkle came out.
All right.
A sparkle came out. That's cool.
Oh, yeah. As long as it doesn't burn the house. Seven people inside, it'll be okay. Let's
like
do another game, which, since we're talking about spirituality.
Ooh. Of course.
André, como é que é o nome, outra vez?
A Taça Tibetana dos Assuntos.
Excellent.
You have to put on your palm.
Yeah, I'm shaking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And oh, yeah.
Now we're talking.
It's okay.
I love
so,
it.
Guys, I have some little papers in here.
Oh.
Some of them might be in Portuguese, but it's okay. Don't worry. We can translate. Each one of you gonna take one, and I'll ask a question about whatever the theme is. Okay. Madalena, quer dizer primeiro?
Should I open?
Yes, please.
Should I share?
Then Pim will do one for you.
Open. Mindfulness.
Ooh, mindfulness. Interesting. Since we were talking about yoga and meditation. Let me see. What's an act of kindness you have experienced recently?
Oh, every day I'm experiencing acts of kindness. So it's hard to choose one.
Do you want to pick the most kind?
Oh.
Maybe? Or one that's impacted you more?
I'd have to think about this.
Because
how can you measure that?
True. Okay.
But yeah, every day I have someone willing to help me carry something or willing to listen to what's happening or just the fact of having someone in the house, for example, that can look at me and already know if I'm doing well or not and approach me in a nice way to make me feel more comfortable. That's already a big act of kindness
that's true,
that I
that's
experience
true.
Every day.
What about
so.
You, Pim?
An act of kindness? Well, pretty much like the same. I mean, in this house for breakfast, for example, I'm talking about that. I like to. It's kind to see people waking up in the good mood and like being and the smile. It's
details, sometimes the little
details,
things.
Details of kindness, yeah. Yes.
The little things sometimes are the most. Because I think, like, usually that's what we least, how do you say it?
Appreciate
yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's sometimes the biggest
stuff
things.
That makes you.
The little stuff sometimes. Yeah. That's true. Pim.
Yep.
Please.
Alright. Okay. Meditation.
Oh, meditation.
Wow. We're so shanty today.
Awesome. Do you find yourself, like, do you recharge, like, your energy, like, by being by yourself or around others? What would you find more? Or maybe a mix of both?
Yeah, maybe both. Yes, I recharge. That's interesting. I mean, I like to be with other people for sure, and to be when I feel like people like me, for example, because they think that I'm a natural cool person, mm-hmm. It is very cool, and it's helpful to recharge the battery, because that's the image that you give to others, it's important, mm-hmm. And when other people, you see them smiling because you're a cool person, it means like it's very cool, so that's the way I recharge, by being amongst others.
Well, when you're alone, do you do like meditation or yoga?
I try to.
Or just like go for a walk? Maybe?
Well, meditation, and I try to use my body in such a way that I know how to fall. For example, I've been practicing judo, martial arts, and stuff.
Yes.
And also, I'm going back to the nunchaku. You know, it's a kind of meditation, because when you're practicing this kind of movement, you just unplug everything and you look at and you try not to hit yourself. And it's also a way of
art itself.
Sure.
It's an escape from reality.
And
when
I saw yesterday the painter Oliver like doing this, and you think like there's something is going on inside. You know, it's like focusing on this little part, but you feel like there is a universe.
What about you, Madalena?
If I recharge myself better being by myself or around people, that was the question, right?
Mm-hmm.
Around people. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I'm a.
Well, from the festivals, you could tell.
Exactly.
Right? Like, you like to be around people.
Yes, I love to be around people and I love to dance. Those are the two things that recharge me the most. So that's why festivals are my happy place. But yeah, I think I'm a very community person. Like, I enjoy having people around me, and it's actually something I've been trying to. Do for myself, to spend more time alone and to make it a daily thing, let's say, to have some time just for myself, because I forget to do it. And when I realize what the only moment I have for myself is when I'm falling in bed already, like,
oh wow,
tired.
Okay.
But it's really important, and since I've been trying to find these moments for myself, I've realized the importance of them.
No,
also
of course,
I think
yes.
Sometimes we get so used to or immersed in exchanging with others that we forget the importance of exchanging within yourself, and that can happen only when you have your
someone
own
around.
Moment. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Would you say like one of your fears would be to be alone?
I think everyone has that fear deep inside your inner child.
She's right.
Its biggest fear is to be left alone.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think it's our condition.
That's true. Okay. So why is it selling secondhand clothes so important to you?
Ooh, many reasons. Come on. Environment. Mm. Going against these big brands that are only focused on profit and don't really look at what they're doing. Again, to the environment. Consumerism. And just the amazing fact that you can get a piece of clothing for half the price you would pay on a Zara.
Oh, yeah.
And
sure.
You're gonna go to a place and nobody else will be dressed like you, so you're gonna be your own authentic self. And it's also fun to buy secondhand, because you go into this place and you have just one piece of everything, and when you find your thing, it will become that amazing piece you have in your wardrobe, you know, because there was a whole ritual about going through all of that. Oh, I love this one, but it's not my size. It doesn't look so good here. And there's not a second option that is smaller or bigger and will fit you better. So it's a whole
and they're really good
finding
quality.
The treasure.
They're really good quality clothes too. I've seen the pictures and they're really good. There's not. It's not just like some random.
Yeah, because I mean, before we started all this big massive production thing, things were made to last. Things were made to have quality. Things were made to be good. So you're actually buying a piece that has been worn by somebody else. So it tells a story. You don't know the story, but there is a story there.
Maybe you feel the energy. In
yes. I mean, if you're into that, yes.
Wow.
If you're not, anyway, you will look pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. They're really good clothes.
And they will last. You will be able to give these clothes to your kids or pass it to your nephews or, you know, just keep it for memory. And they will be good. Nowadays, you buy a pair of pants. After a year, you squat and the rips open. You know,
it's true.
It
it's
has
true.
Happened.
And they're so expensive. They're so expensive
squat for no reason.
Yeah. So it's I think it's an important movement. Just not just about buying secondhand clothing, but secondhand everything, furniture, anything that you can get for yourself that has already been used. Is a big help.
Recycle, reuse, reduce, right?
Exactly. And there's a fourth.
Oh, that's cool.
There's a fourth one?
Yes. Oh,
recycle, reuse, reduce.
Reduce and recycle, reuse, reduce, I don't remember.
Okay, okay.
Remember, maybe.
Remember.
Remake.
Remake.
Remember.
Recycle, reuse. Yeah.
Okay, anyways. you have the Escola Normal.
Yeah.
And you recently shown the movie, right? Talk a bit about that. What the passion about movie, the movies, and because on the description you said you could bring your own pillow and blankets and all that.
Yeah.
So you're trying to create a cozy environment.
Exactly.
For everybody to be comfortable. Talk about that.
So yeah, we decided to do this Wednesday movie nights, and this last Wednesday was the first, and Kat, Katarina, she was the one choosing this first movie, which is a French movie from
70 something.
La Belle,
La Belle Verte.
La Belle Verte.
No, not 70. No, it's 80 or
80 something.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Yeah. Well, it's vintage. and yeah, we really wanted to. It was our first tryout to bring more people into the house because until now we were just trying to fix and make everything look nice. And exactly, we just wanted people to come, get to know the space, and feel like this is a cozy environment and yeah, just snuggle in with the blanket. We offer tea, we offer popcorn.
Do you feel like it's important in Madeira to open more room for this kind of opportunity where you can come in, welcome people and to be able to watch movies?
Yeah, not just movies.
We don't see that a lot. Usually people go to like the commercial movies in Madeira Shopping or Forum Madeira and just go watch a movie, commercial movie.
So I know now there's already some people doing that. So they're trying to bring to the island different movies that are not just the mainstream ones, let's say, and congratulations for that. And we wanted also to create that space because for me, I'm the only person from Madeira in that house, in the seven people there. And something I really struggled growing up here was with acceptance or even having the chance to meet people that are not the people I see every day in my small circle. I feel that now it's changing a bit because ever since Corona, we have more foreigners, younger foreigners coming and they like this here, nomads. So there's this whole new
is
vibe
growing.
Is...
Like the nomad group is growing.
But we forget about the locals. We have so many people here in the island that have different ideas, that think, you know, in a more, I don't want to say open or closed way, but that have a different way of seeing things. And I feel that we don't really find the space for that exchange to happen. Because you get a bit closed on the friends you know since childhood or, you know, the circles of people, and it's really cool to have a place where you can break that and just be like, hey, come and let's do something together.
And that's a little bit why we do Relampada as well, because mm-hmm. we want to bring to the attention of people that there's a lot in Madeira that can be done. There's a lot of interesting people that we can talk to, like you guys.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of projects that can be created by, as long as people are willing to join forces
exactly.
and all that.
And
like you guys are doing
you
in your house. Like that's amazing with the movies and other projects as well. Like Pam, yeah. you probably have other projects that you are working with people that you're living with as well. Mm-hmm. Do you want to talk about that before we leave? Leave, finish.
Talk about what?
Any projects that you guys are working on besides
no,
the movies?
It's a secret from them.
Oh, it's a secret from them.
No.
Okay.
I am working on a like on project with people in the house.
Yes.
Oh. Oh.
Mm. Besides the movie one, no.
You
movie.
Want me to take over?
I don't know. Like yeah, jam sessions.
The jam sessions.
The jam sessions.
Well, there is a person from Iceland that came like 2 days ago, and he's a singer too.
Yeah.
And he said, "I'm gonna teach him judo, and he's gonna teach me how to sing." That's we decided that.
Oh, that's pretty cool. You like swap skills, an exchange of skills. That's
yes,
good.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Say,
okay.
Yeah?
Interesting.
Okay,
that's really
so
interesting.
We'll see.
Okay, guys. I don't know. I think we're finished.
Oh.
I think it was great, right? Do you guys want to talk about anything else before we leave? Like anything you want to plug in, maybe?
Yeah, I think if I can.
You can, of course you can. That's
you
why
you
this is a safe space.
It's a safe space, Melinda. Right.
Safe space
No, I just wanted to say that, I mean, Escola Feliz, a Escola Feliz, now I'm mixing Escola Normal.
And Feliz
yeah.
Coletivo.
Feliz Coletivo,
oh, cool.
Escola
Feliz.
Feliz.
Wow, that's cool, actually. Yeah.
Mas o que eu queria dizer, então vou falar em português, é que nós queremos ter este espaço, ou estamos a começar este espaço que está aqui há nem 2 meses. Exatamente para isso, quem aqui na ilha tiver vontade de fazer coisas diferentes, de trazer um projeto, de conhecer pessoas com visão artística, cultural, ou simplesmente trocar ideias sobre coisas que possamos fazer aqui para dinamizar a parte cultural da ilha, venham falar connosco, venham ter lá a casa, já sabem a morada, andei um bocadinho para trás no vídeo,
exatamente.
E hoje a morada. E nós vamos estar a fazer coisas todas as semanas, desde as noites de cinema, as jam sessions, queremos ter também as sessões de pintura, de meditação, quem sabe workshops de teatro. Portanto, é um espaço multifuncional,
toda a gente
aberto a quem quiser experimentar e trocar. É essa a ideia que nós estamos aqui a trazer, porque é a escola normal, é para aprendermos todos uns com os outros e crescermos. Outros.
Sejam todos como
abrimos,
vocês
abrimos
também.
Ramos, exato.
Exatamente, é fantástico. Pim, anything? Anything you want to add?
Well, I think I don't speak Portuguese, but I picked
Do you speak Portuguese better when you drink?
Yes, probably. Yeah.
Okay.
Shut, I picked up a few words, and I think that's what she said. It's like it's cool because it's a multifunctional spot, and
space,
I feel like there is a convergence of cool stuff happening.
Yeah.
So that's yeah. Pretty much, I'm confident about the future because, it's really cool to have people and to feel like you are living with people on the same wave that you
mm-hmm.
are. Like,
totally. Were you impressed by Madeira when you came in? Like, when you arrived, were you like, oh, this is really nice? Like, I don't regret coming in.
No, not at all. And I've traveled quite a lot in my life, so it's not like, okay, that's cool because it's sunny or something. It's like you feel like the people you meet. You think that you've met them before, you know?
Yeah,
it's like,
that's true.
So
it's the energy, it's the way they are. Like,
yes.
I also travel a lot and I met a lot of people that are quite similar to one another. Like the way they talk, the mannerisms,
yeah,
all of that.
Yes,
like,
absolutely.
Oh, I've met someone like
yeah,
you, but
yeah,
fuck,
exactly. It's a type of personality.
Yes, yes.
Sometimes you
okay,
you
I'm not the only one who sees that.
No. That's
wow.
true. That's
okay,
awesome.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, by the way, you remind me of a very good friend of mine.
I do?
Yeah. Oh, cool. Oh,
all right. Amazing. All right, guys. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
You were delightful. Thank you for being so cool.
Thank you. This was awesome.
I'm going to turn to Portugal. Olá. Ok, pessoal. Muito obrigado por estarem connosco neste meu primeiro episódio da Relampada. Eu fui o vosso host, Francisco Corte. Não se esqueçam de deixar um like e subscrever ao canal. E eu gostaria novamente de agradecer aos nossos sponsors, ao Bacardi Martini, por nos dar estas bebidas, à Tulipa, por estas flores magníficas que dão-nos aqui um ar todo florestal e selvagem. E claro também ao Estúdio 21 que nos deu esse espaço fantástico. Obrigado e pronto, pá. Voltem sempre, ok pessoal?
Yes.
E vou agora levar esta garrafa, que isto é um pagamento e ainda tenho outra coisa. Tchau pessoal, força! Papada!
Bisu!